What's happening, everybody? Welcome to Marvelous Statues. As always, I'm George, and today I'll be doing my first segment of collecting news, where I'll be discussing collectibles that are up and coming that you may otherwise not be aware of. This week, I was fortunate enough to go to Star Wars Celebration. I want to thank my buddies Seth and Eric for joining me on this adventure. We had a blast. Really needed more than one day to take it all in. There was so much to do and see. It was fun. I really wanted to get into the Last Jedi panel, but unfortunately, I found out from other people that there was people actually sleeping there from the night before just to be able to get into the panel. So there was just no way that I could do it. I found out that they unveiled the Last Jedi trailer during that panel. I was able to see that. It was awesome. I laughed, I cried. It was everything I wanted it to be. I'm very excited to see that movie. It comes out in December. If you haven't seen the trailer yet, I included a link below so that you can check it out. Now, among the many things that I did there, I was able to sit in the Star Wars Collectibles update panel where several different licensees discussed the up-and-coming projects that they have and the items that will be available this year. Of the ones that presented, here are some of the ones that interested me. Roar Selengar is a company that's been in business since 1885. They are not a new company, but they are new to the Star Wars collectibles industry, and they focus on highly precise collectibles that are created out of pewter. I've included a link to their site below. They have collectibles from Star Wars as well as Lord of the Rings and even Captain America. You should check it out. They really do have some cool stuff to see. EFX also presented. They're a company that's well known for their highly movie accurate helmets. They showed off their chrome plated Darth Vader and Stormtrooper helmet to commemorate the 40th anniversary of Star Wars. They also announced that they'll be releasing a line of lightsabers and other movie props to fill the void that was left when Master Replicas went out of business. Now this I'm really excited about. Years ago, I used to own several different lightsabers from Master Replicas. I had to let them all go throughout my moves, but I would love to have them in my collection again. Now the lightsabers will be released with their counterparts, so there'll be two lightsabers in each kit, one with the light side and one with the dark side. So for example, if you got the Obi-Wan saber, you were also gonna get the Darth Vader saber. So I think that's pretty cool. They will also be releasing a line of vehicles that are highly movie accurate. So you'll have the Millennium Falcon, Star Destroyer, AT-ST, just to name a few, available this year. Cotobukiya was also there, and they revealed their latest in their Artifacts and Artifacts Plus lines. I particularly like the two-pack that they have. It comes with two characters that can be displayed on the base in any way that you desire, and then it comes with attachments so that you can set it up in a way that you prefer. And some of the kits will also come with light-up features, so that's pretty cool as well. Gentle Giant was there, and they discussed their Premium Guild membership plans. So basically, there are three levels to this plan. There's a Platinum, which costs 150, a Gold, which is 100, and a Silver, which is 50. As a sign-up perk, you're allowed to pick from their exclusive products as a free gift for signing up. You also get a coupon for $35 off any one item that's available on their site, a discount for all items that are on sale, and first crack at con exclusives that are available on their site. This year, one of the gifts that you can pick from for signing up is the Darth Revan 1/8 scale statue that will be coming out. This is a very awesome piece. I've been a big fan of Darth Revan for a long time, so that absolutely sold me. So I'm now a Platinum member. You can check out what's available with their other plans and other exclusive items that you can get on their site. Now, Bandai was there to talk about their Star Wars model kits. Now, these kits do not require the use of glue. They're snap to fit. They're highly detailed and screen accurate models. Now at their booth, they had a Star Destroyer that was 3.5 feet long. It was insanely detailed. It had light up features, which don't normally come with the kit, but was a nice touch. And it took me back to my days when I used to build these models that came from Kenner. It was awesome. They also had this recreation of the trench run from A New Hope. It was really nice to see. Definitely something that you should check out. Lastly, Sideshow Collectibles was there in a big way. They had this huge display with the legendary scales of Vader and C-3PO. They had life-size Darth Vader, a life-size Boba Fett. Almost all, I think all, of the premium format statue line from Star Wars. The 1/6 scale line Star Wars was there. The Hot Toys was there. They even had the Ralph McQuarrie statues to take a look at. It was really cool. At the panel, they discussed the Boba Fett statue premium format in length. They went over the details that come with that statue. They also gave us a sneak peek at the Luke and Han Solo Hoth statues that will be available soon. Now, one of the items that they talked about that particularly interested me was the Han Solo and Carbonite 1/6 scale collectible. What I liked about it is that they gave you two different options for display. One was the upright position that we see Han in the Empire Strikes Back when he's first encased in the Carbonite. And then the second is the option to have him floating on the base so that you can recreate the scene that Boba Fett is transporting him onto the Slave One. So that was kind of cool. So that was it. Again, I had a great time at this event. I met a lot of fun people who are into Star Wars as much, if not more so than me. And I look forward to my next celebration. So currently, I'm in the process of reviewing the Wolverine and Hulk maquette from Sideshow Collectibles. That should be coming out pretty soon, so stay tuned. Again, you can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter if you ever feel like chatting. And until next time, may the Force be with you.